Hello, everybody. Decided to take a break from the retro this week. Who says I don't play anything new and popular? And oh boy, is this one popular at the moment. So in order to get some of those sweet YouTube algorithm views, let's play Spider-Man on the PS4. I thought we'd begin up high. Here we are at the very top of the Empire State Building, enjoying the view. I thought we'd do a little sightseeing first, so off we drop. So yes, Spider-Man by Insomniac, a beautiful, beautiful game where we play the titular Spider-Mang in an incredible, albeit slightly scaled down, replica of New York, complete with plenty of real-world locations such as the Empire State Building we just fell from, and the Flatiron Building, Madison Square Garden. Doesn't look too square to me. Oi, oi! Central Park! And everybody's favourite, that church! You know, the one we all remember. Of course, aside from real-world locations, being a Marvel game, it has locations from what we like to call the 616 reality. As you can see, we're approaching Avengers Tower, up on the Upper East Side. Let's have a knock on the door, see if we can get any help with our superheroing. That's the great thing with Marvel's New York. There's about 3 superheroes to every normal human being. You're never without backup. Hello? Anyone home? Come on, Tony, you Iron Man, you. I know you can't resist the spotlight. No? Cap? You there, man? Thor? Come on, my Odin son. For fuck's sake. You know what, I'm not fussy. I'll even settle for Hawkeye at this point. So, getting help with the Avengers was a bust, so we've headed down to 1778 Bleecker Street, the Sanctum Sanctorum. Dr. Stephen Strange, show yourself! No? Oh, now you're taking the piss. He's not here either. Wong? He's not white, that's for sure. Right, Danny, mate. I know you're in there. You cannot tell me you're doing anything important right now. All you've got going on at the moment is that mediocre Netflix show, for crying out loud. Have a fucking no show. Not a single superhero in the city apart from me. Where the fuck are they all? Kicking Galactus up the bum. If only there was somebody who I could call. Nah. Before we continue a little further, as you can see, I've unlocked a few costumes. Only one choice for me, though. The traditional red and blues. Seriously, fuck this white spider suit shit. Sorry, Insomniac, I see a white elephant spider elephant when I see it. Since when has Spider-Man ever needed an armoured bright section on his costume to draw the bad guy's attention? Spider-Man has spider sense. For fuck's sake, this is the type of shit that Batman used to do, and he even knocked it on the head years ago as a bad idea. Okay, so I guess we really should do something. After all, I'm a hero and I should be fighting crime. And because I'm a slightly dodgy vigilante type, I've already tapped into the police radio frequencies, which means I can scan the area for crimes. And here's one right now! Hello, lads. How's it going? Get ready to get messy. Web spaff attack! Amazing how exhausted yet satisfied you feel after one of those moments. Uh-oh, they have backup. Now, the combat in this is best put as alchemy, which, as a member of the School of Devil May Cry, Ninja Gaiden, Bayonetta, I'm not too thrilled about. But at least it feels a little less canned than the other games that use it in a bit more free form. After all, I am to Spider-Mang. To Spider-Mang, I do whatever a spider can. I eat flies, I eat ants, I scare housewives and elephants. Watch out! I am to Spider-Mang. Of course, it's not all fun and games and street-level crime. There's a story too, and just to catch you up, I've just helped put Wilson Fisk, the kingpin of crime, in jail. It seems like it's left a bit of a power vacuum in the city, though, and some black and white mask fuckers are all over the place causing chaos. Apparently, they're causing somewhat of a furore at one of Fisk's building sites, and well, I thought I'd look into it. Now, this is the perfect situation for me to show off some stealthy spider skills. Nope. fucked it, spotted. I guess fisticuffs will have to do. Kind of a shame, really, because if I had been just a little bit more sneaky, I would have been able to deal with this without making so much of a mess. Unless you count the dozens of men all hanging around, covered in sticky white fluid, of course. The semen jokes, they never stop. They never stop. Ooh, we got chinned. Okay, you know that little thing at the building site? It's taken a little turn for the worst. As you can see, a crane has toppled over and I kind of had to web that up, and there's a helicopter flying off into the distance with a large hunk of metal webbed to it because, well, I fucked up. And now it's wrecking the city. Damage control are going to have some work to do after I'm done with this. No mistake. You know, sometimes I think J.J. Jameson is right. I am a fucking menace. Time to fix your dirty, filthy mess, Spider-Man. Oh my god, oh my god, I have made things worse. I have made things a whole lot fucking worse. So, we've made it onto the helicopter, and clearly the best approach to stopping this is rip the rotor engines out and make it potentially crash into the busy New York streets below, causing massive casualties. Right you are. I swear, the further I go along with this, the more I'm starting to agree with JJ. This seems reckless, just bloody reckless. Yep, we're gonna die. And if I don't die, one of these big ass chunks of metal will hit a civvy and they'll die. I'm not usually one to shift blame or anything, but this wouldn't be happening if the Avengers were around to help out. Well, most of them. Not Hawkeye, of course. What would he do? Shoot an arrow at it? Oh, fuck. And just like that, Spider-Man was dead, along with 100 people dining at a small cafe at the corner of the street. Oh, and some guy called Peter Parker was found in the wreckage, absolutely stark bollock naked. I don't know what that was all about. On the evening news that night, Avengers spokesman Tony Stark was quoted to say, "We all ignored him as a joke. It was Hawkeye's idea. He's such a funny guy. We love Hawkeye." Yeah, of course you fucking do. Until next time. Bye!